Hello! Today I am going to show you how to draw just some basic snowflakes, and then I'm going to set you free to draw your own big fancy snowflake. So, the first one I'm going to start with is this one. And all of these snowflakes, we're just going to make kind of an asterisk. So you're going to make like a plus and then an X. So I'll show you how to do it in this one. So first I'm going to make a cross, like a plus sign, and then we're going to make an X through it. So just get where you have your plus sign and your X. And then all we're going to do for this one, it's so simple. We're going to go around and we're just going to make a little V at the end of each one. This is as simple as it gets, my friends. That is your number one very simple snowflake. You can go back and embellish it later after I teach you these other things. But let's move on to number two. We're gonna do the same thing. We make the cross and the X. So let's make our cross and our X. So on this one, we did the same thing to each little piece of our snowflake. On this one, on our cross, we're going to do certain things, and on our X, we're going to do certain things. But first, we're going to go in between each little section and make this curvy little point. So in between every two sections, just kind of go up and make a curvy little point. And I like to move my paper around because this makes all of the shapes very similar. Sometimes if I'm drawing a shape with my hand in a different direction, it's gonna look different. So I'm just twisting my paper around. So now we have this neat little kind of a poinsettia look in the middle. And then on our plus here, all we're gonna do is make a very wide V at the end of each of these. So it's just a very wide V. And we're only going to do that on these four. We're not going to do it on all of them. So now it should look like this. And you can probably see my pencil marks and know that next, we're just going to go on our X shape here and we're going to make three V's. And the last V is going to be at the very end. So one, two, three. And we'll do the same on this one. One, two, three. And then we'll do the same on this one. One, two, three. And there we have a different snowflake. So it's just a lot of symmetry. It's a lot of just making little lines the same way. Now let's go over here to snowflake number three. And this is another one. It's like one. It's another one where we're going to do the same thing to each little piece of snowflake. So the first thing I'm going to do is come in and put my cross, my plus sign, and then my X. So we've got kind of our asterisk made now. And then, this is pretty simple. So on every single one, we're gonna come in and we're gonna do just a little arch at the end. So it's just an arch. And we're gonna sort of just try to make them all the same size. If they're different sizes, that's all right. It's gonna kind of look just fine if they're all basically the same. There we go. So we've got those done. And then on all the same ones, I'm just going to go and I'm going to put a littler curve. on all of these. And I do like to turn my paper. It just makes it a little more uniform. You don't have to turn your paper, but it works well for me when I do. So this is just kind of, this is kind of our smiley snowflake. It's just a lot of little smiles. So there we have it. That one's done. Now we're gonna work on number four, which is gonna just be a little tiny bit fancier. I'm kind of showing you some different ways to do this. So when you try to do your own, you'll have a little idea of what to do. All right, so we're gonna start like the rest with our plus sign, kind of our central cross here. And then we're gonna add our X. So we've started out with our asterisk like we did on the others. The first thing I'm gonna do on this one is just make a little pie here in the middle, and I'm gonna color the whole thing in. Now, on the ends of our X, let's also make a little dot. Color it in. All right, so there's all four ends of our X. And then on those same ones, I'm gonna make a little heart here in the middle. So I'm just going up and down, make that little arch and come to the point. And then I'm gonna make the little arch and come to the point for kind of a little heart over there. And on the last one, same thing. So we're getting closer. Now, kind of between each of these dots, I'm gonna make a smaller dot here. So I'm gonna do the same thing down here. And then halfway between here, little dot. And then halfway between here, a little dot. So now we've got some dots. And I think the snowflake needs some little straight pieces, some little angular edges. So I'm gonna go ahead and put a V at the top of each of these remaining ones. So let's do a V. So we've got our V's, and then underneath it, I'm gonna do a second V. So now we have the two V's, and then I'm gonna come back and put one, but underneath this dot. And it can be a little bit bigger if you want it to. So kind of the rule of snowflakes, I would say, is you just wanna do the same thing. So to all of your crosses, you wanna do the same thing, and to all of your X's, you wanna do the same thing. So these are kind of some basic ways to do a snowflake. And then what I would like for you to do is to try to make your own. So make your own asterisk and then kind of think your way through it. Try to make your own and do some different things. And now that we've done all of these things, you can think about going and maybe adding some more things into this one. All right. So I don't have a plan for this one. I'm just totally gonna wing it. Here we go. I think for the middle, I'm gonna do a little angles like this to make this fun little shape in the center. So I've kind of just gone around. It looks a little spider webby, but I think it's gonna be great. All right, so now I'm gonna work on my pluses. So I'm gonna do, let's do a little diamond shape here. and I'm skipping every other because I'm only doing it on the ones that are part of the plus, not the ones that are part of the X. So then what can we do? We can have a little stripe above it. And then maybe some V's. All right, so we're back at the top, and now I need to think again. I think I'm gonna do a wider V above that. So we'll go wider. Wider here. And wider here. All right. And then maybe even wider. So let's go even wider. And then wider here. So then what should we do to the top of this one? Let's think. It's a nice shape. Let's do like a little, I'm gonna do a little teardrop shape on the top of each of these. So there we go. And now we have some pretty good symmetry going on here. And then we can decide what we want to do to these. And I think I'm going to work maybe from the outside in. So let's see. I'm going to have a straight across piece on each of these. And then because everything doesn't have actually have to be connected in a snowflake, so I'm going to do a round dot on the top of each one. It's not even connected and it's fine. All right, so we've got these angular shapes here. So maybe I'll do a little series of smiles. So I'm going to do three smiles. One, two, three. And one, two, three. And one, two, three. So now I still have plenty of space here. I think I'm going to go ahead and do a little heart. You can fit all kinds of fun shapes into these. You can fit like hearts and flowers. And it's kind of like just whatever you do to one, do to the others. So now we still have a little space here. So I think I'm going to put two dots. So there's two dots, one, two, one, two, one, two, and then we've kind of got a snowflake here. Now you can add all sorts of little embellishments if you want. So I'm gonna put a little dot at the top here. 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 And here. And then I'm kind of looking at these thinking, what could we do to those to make them more fun? So maybe let's do branches at the end. just little branches. And then we'll go find the next set and do little branches at the end of that one. You could go on and you could just do so many little details. This is a great way to just spend some time letting your mind go and just be very creative. Ah, I did too. All right, no one's gonna know if we don't tell them. Or I can just do that to all the rest of them. Which may not be a terrible idea, because that looks really cute. All right, I think I'm gonna do it. These ones on the ends are getting another set of arms. And we could always do that to the other ones too. If you've got time and you want to add more things, you always can. All right, so I've got a pretty good looking snowflake going here. I'm loving it. What else can we do? Let's maybe add a little triangle in each of these. Little slices of pizza in our snowflake. So all of these elements, you can kind of just keep adding to your heart's desire. I'm liking the way this one looks a lot right now. So I think I'm going to go ahead and stop and I'm going to sign it. So there we have it. That is how you do a snowflake. And then here were our little easy practice ones from the beginning. So you can see how we took the things that we learned here and we kind of just made a big fancy one. Great work, everybody.